say they'd never grow tired talking about the miracle on the Hudson or about the bond they now share that grew out of that harrowing experience.
There aren't any really words that go with it. You just kind of lived it, and you don't have to explain it. You just look at one another, and you know, yeah, we did do that together.
Many of the passengers say they stay in touch with one another and with the hero of the Hudson, Captain Sully.
Can you tell us what you write to Captain Sully? You say you write to him on a regular. What is it you tell him?
Oh, no, just little things like, I went to my granddaughter's school and she declared you her hero. And
the hero who successfully landed a commercial jetliner on the Hudson River shook hands, posed for pictures, and shared hugs with passengers and their families. During a town hall meeting, Sully told the crowd there was no way to properly train for what happened.
In our flight simulators at the time, it was not possible to practice a water landing. The data don't exist. They aren't programmed for it. So the only training we'd ever gotten for a water landing was reading a few paragraphs in a manual and having a theoretical classroom discussion.
Just got to grow up with the best mom in the world.
Among those celebrating the 10th anniversary, the daughter of one of the passengers who was just 9 years old when the flight from New York to Charlotte went down.
And then I just think about at the end of the day just how lucky I am to have her, and just how different things would be if, you know, she hadn't walked away that day, and I'm just overcome with gratitude.
Mom says the experience changed her whole perspective on life.
A tremendous life responsibility that comes with thinking your life has ended and then all of a sudden it's not.
Each passenger we talked with told us their name and their seat number. The seat number, another part of the experience they never forget. In Charlotte, I'm Bill O'Neill, WXII 12 News.